Okay, two things here. One, I still get many questions about shipping from Amazon, eBay, Etsy, all these other stores in the US to Kenya. And number two, this coming Friday is gonna be Black Friday, and there's gonna be a lot of deals on Amazon, probably other websites, Newegg, and so on. And for you guys who ship from the US to Kenya for reasons like, you know, good prices and availability of stuff which you might not find locally, let's make an update video. I just want to share with you guys what has happened and what has changed since I made that video that you guys have watched 20,000 times on this channel. Let's get started. Now over here on my computer, I have Amazon opened, and you guys, if you want to shop on Amazon and you'd like to support me for this kind of work, please use the link that is provided just under this video. I'll have a link down below to the Black Friday deals. If you want to score something, you'll just pay the deal cost at no extra charge to you, and I might get something small, who knows. So now I'd like to buy this mouse, the Logitech G305 Lightspeed Wireless Gaming Mouse, Hero 12K sensor, whatever all this description is saying. Behind the scenes, there's actually two real reasons that I want to get this G305. Number one, the truth is it's available in white. You know, the PC is white, the keyboard is white, the lamp is white, the table is white, but this MX Master is black. And number two, this MX Master has served me graciously, very faithfully for the past more than 5 years. It's done well, it's still working, but 5 years is quite a long time to run a single mouse. There's a thumb button over here that really has got mushy and so on. At some point I had to open it to, you know, repair something. It's just gotten, you know, dirty and old. I think in as much as it works, let's get another one, yeah? So G305, it's had very high ratings over the past, like, you know, 3 years that it's been in existence, and it offers quite some good value for money. It normally costs $50, but as you can see, there's a deal right now. It's one of the Black Friday deals, and you know, this coming Friday is gonna be the culmination of Black Friday. If there's something on your wish list, chances are you might get a deal on it. Just go over to Amazon and check, find out, you might get a deal. So as you can see right now, the mouse goes for $30. I'm going to save $20. Basically, to make your purchase on Amazon, first you need to log in. And as you can see, I have logged in. If you can't log in, probably don't have an account, create an Amazon account. And one thing with the Black Friday coming is actually get into the Amazon Prime. Normally, Amazon Prime gets you fast and free shipping within the US. You know, what we're going to do over here is we're going to ship from Amazon to some intermediary, some service that actually ships to Kenya, because Amazon does not ship directly to Kenya, though they do actually ship some commodities to Kenya, but mostly it's better to ship using these third-party agents because they are cheaper in terms of tax. If you ship directly from Amazon to Kenya, chances are you'll be hit with some good tax. And there's actually some convenience in letting these guys handle your shipment. Okay, now what we need to do is to add the item to the cart. Just add to cart. Now there's all these other things that they offer, 4 year office equipment plan and so on. Say no thanks. Some other stuff here, advertisements and so on, just ignore those. Proceed to checkout. One item. Now this is where the game starts. First, shipping address. As I already told you guys earlier, we're going to use a third-party shipping company to ship our mouse from the US to Kenya. The company in this case is called Aquantuo. An interesting name, but I bumped into this company on Twitter. They actually sort of advertised to me on Twitter. I decided to check them out, and I promised you guys that I will check out a couple of companies and compare them and make a video. But really, since I stumbled upon Aquantuo, I haven't really used anything else. I think they're my favorite right now, and I'd actually recommend them for reasons as one. Their customer service is actually quite good. They update you wherever your stuff is. Number two, they're actually quite cheap. Right now, Aquantuo actually charges $13 per kg to Kenya. There's many other companies. It's not like this Aquantuo are sponsoring me. I just think they're a good company because I have experiences shipping with them and everything was smooth. In fact, even this microphone, you guys, this is actually what you're hearing right now. This is a Comica VM20. I shipped this microphone using Aquantuo and so many other things. So yeah. Can you see it? I hope not. Oh, looks like you can still see it. Okay, so yeah, basically this is to say that I have actually used this company. But something else you might want to consider is the bulk of the item you are shipping. As you can see, most of these companies that ship from US to Kenya, be it States Duka, there's V2 Mob, there's Kentex, there's Savosto, and so many others, charge per kg. Normally, whatever you are shipping is weighed, and you'll be charged $15 per kg. That's like $1,700 thereabout. And everyone keeps asking me in the comments whether or not you'll pay tax or something else once your items land in Kenya. The answer is you are not going to pay anything else apart from that $15 per kg, or in the case of Aquantuo, $13 per kg that you'll pay. I think this guy is sort of like pay import duty in bulk for all the stuff they ship. I don't know how they calculate, but yeah, you won't pay anything else. Now, what I was saying is, if you are going to ship bulky items that are like, you know, 10 kgs, 20 kgs, if you want to ship like a home theater system or such bulky stuff, it's advisable to use sea shipping, actually ship via sea. I have never tried them, but you can check their rates on their website. But for small items like a mouse, shoes, or anything small, it's always better to use air shipping, because one, it's faster, you will receive your stuff like with Aquantuo within 2 weeks. But note that right now, with the Black Friday deals coming, a lot of guys are going to be shopping for Christmas and so on, which usually causes delays. In fact, I remember I actually bought this mouse on Amazon on a Black Friday, I think 5 years ago. So note that there might be delays, but normally Aquantuo takes at most 2 weeks. Sometimes they would even deliver even in like 10 days. I know sometimes the likes of Kentex can be a bit slower because they're actually a bigger company. They have more customers, so they have a lot of stuff to sort through before they ship. And so, yeah, that's actually an upside when you're shipping with these other smaller companies like Aquantuo and so on. But the Aquantuo actually ships also to Ghana and Kenya, so they're not really a small company. So yeah, in this case, we need to open an account on the Aquantuo website, and you can see over here we're on aquantuo.com. So if you've never used them, you need to go and sign up over here. But for me, I already have an account, so what I'll do, I'll just log in. Now, as you can see, once you log in, you are brought over to this dashboard, and over here you tell them what stuff you're shipping so that they know that there's a mouse coming from Amazon and it belongs to Dickenns, so it needs to go to Kenya to this address. And so this dashboard enables you to create a shipping request to request them, you know, to ship your stuff. Now, once you've created an account with Aquantuo, they give you an address that you'll actually enter on your Amazon account as your shipping address. And there's some other information that you can get over here on your dashboard, like price estimator to estimate, you know, how much you will be charged. My Aquantuo addresses here, you see they give you a US address. This is what you will enter on Amazon. There's a Canada address they give you, assuming you're going to buy some stuff from a Canadian store. There's a UK address, so these guys also ship from the UK. There's a China address, like if you're gonna ship from, you know, Alibaba or AliExpress, you can use this address. So they ship from UK, China, Canada, US. So in this case, we're going to use the US address. And the good thing with Aquantuo, they actually ship to a state called Delaware, a city called Wyoming. You know, us Kenyans like to save as much as we can. So Delaware is a nice state to ship to compared to the likes of Kentex, who ship, I think, to California. Because there's no sales tax. And you can see here on my Amazon checkout that you see the item costs $30. Shipping and handling is $0 because, you know, I signed up for Amazon Prime. And I told you, get Amazon Prime for free. You'll cancel it after you ship your stuff. So yeah, get Amazon Prime. They will offer you free 1 month trial. Get it. Then after you ship your stuff, you just cancel it, you know. Then you can see that total before tax is $30. Then estimated tax to be collected is zero. Why? Because I'm shipping to Delaware. But if you ship to, you know, like California, for example, using Kentex, California actually has a sales tax. You might get like some $2 or $3 over here, which will increase your total cost. Good thing is it's not as bad as the taxes over here. But still, if you want to save a little bit, you can use Aquantuo because they ship to Delaware. So yeah, my shipping address over here is actually the address that I was given by Aquantuo. Your US address is this, and so on. Then for the payment method, I normally use Visa, and it's already over there because, you know, it's saved in my Amazon account. The billing address is normally the address on your account, and it's a Kenyan address, and that's what I've entered over here. Then review items and shipping. This stuff you can basically ignore, and you can see the delivery date is going to be November 24th, 2021, if I order in the next 11 hours and 20 minutes. And today is 21st, so that's going to be like 3 days to deliver the stuff from Amazon to Delaware, and that's the Aquantuo warehouse. So if I was going to use Kentex, for example, I'd enter here the Kentex address that they would give me, and it would be taken to, I think, California, where Kentex warehouses their stuff before shipping to Kenya. If I was using like Savostore, I think they do Texas. My shipping address would have been that address, so it would go to Texas. So what happens is once my stuff arrives at Aquantuo's address, they will forward it to Kenya, and they normally ship once a week. So yeah, I expect that in the next like 2 weeks, I should get my stuff. So as you can see here, the total is 3,478.61. Amazon actually has this function where they give you a payment total in the currency on your card, in this case Kenyan shillings, and I always advise that just pay using Kenyan shillings. Don't select your payment currency as US dollars, because if you pay in US dollars, the amount that will be deducted from your bank account, assuming you're using Visa like in my case, will probably be higher, because the exchange rates in our banks are normally a bit higher than what Amazon is offering. As you can see here, the exchange rate on Amazon is 115 Kenyan shillings for a dollar. So basically what I'll be charged is 34.78, but if I chose USD, my bank will convert using whatever rate they are using, and they will charge me probably more than this. So yeah, just choose Kenyan shillings. So once that is done, I just say place order in Kenyan shillings, and that is it. Order placed. Thank you. Now it will take some time for Amazon to process the order, usually about 1 day. When they ship the order, they'll send you an email, and you need to take note of the tracking number that you'll be given. And that tracking number is what you're going to give Aquantuo or Kentex or Savostore, whoever you're using. In this case, I just say create request and choose this first option, your online purchases, or mail a package to us. And you can see these are some of the stuff that they have shipped to me. So what I'll do is just add an item and give them the details of the item and wait. Now, one other thing that you need to take note of is these companies normally have some freight insurance that they charge. For most of them, Aquantuo as an example, they will charge, I think, 5% of the value of the items you'll ship as insurance in case your stuff gets damaged or gets lost. But usually that insurance is charged for items that cost above a certain amount. It will be like $100 or $200. Above that, you pay an extra 5% of the cost of the item that you are shipping. Just find out from the website, or you can call these guys, ask them exactly how much they're shipping. But for this month that just cost me $30, they're not going to charge me any freight insurance. Basically, that is it. That is how I ship from Amazon to Kenya in 2021. If you found this video helpful, you know what to do. Smash that like button down there. And if you're not subscribed, feel very free. You're welcome aboard. Join this great family. We are now, how many? 6,000 of us? Yeah. Thanks to everyone who has subscribed and hit that notification bell so that you do not miss any of such videos that I make weekly. See you guys in the next one. And as always, no pressure.